In this code sample, you will find it hopefully kind of interesting. What it does is it codes a palindrome. A palindrome is when you take a word or a sentence or a bunch of words, reverse its contents, and see if it equals what it was before you reverse it, and that's considered palindrome. So what we do is we do some different kind of loop processing here, and I hope you this will expand your learning. So what we do right here is we create a Boolean call b, b being Hungarian notation for Boolean, stay in loop, we set it to true. And we have a while loop. And the while loop ends all the way down here. So everything in between is encapsulated in it. We have a variable called sReverseValue that we set to a blank, and we prompt the user, enter a word or phrase, click the cancel button to exit the program. So the first thing we do is we take what was entered and put into a variable called sInput. And we say if sInput equals a null, we break. And if you remember from the reading, a break breaks you out of the loop. So what happens is, this is the beginning of the while loop, this is the end, and the break will break you to here and out. So that's an elegant way of exiting a loop. And what we do here is we say if what you entered equals a blank, which means you didn't specify anything to reverse, we do a continue. The continue brings you to the top of the loop. Break breaks you out of the loop, continue brings you back up to the top, and we keep asking them for input until they give it to us. Okay, so right here we have a for loop. And what we basically are going to use this for loop is to read from the end of what was ever entered to the beginning. So right here we have I count equals the length of the string minus 1. We're building on what we already learned about strings. And there's a length property, minus 1. We're going to stay in the loop as long as the count is greater than or equal to 0. And we're going to decrement. So this is a backwards processing loop. So we have a string. So for example, I put in the value Bob. Bob is 3 characters long. So the length of it is 3 minus 1 is 2. And as long as we're greater than 0, because strings start in 0 and then it ends at the length minus 1, which in the case of Bob would be, we go 0 would be B, 1 would be O, and 2 would be B again, and we decrement. So basically we take the string, we process from the back forward like this, and we build a new string. Notice concatenation operation in the character at method of the string. And then what we do is we put it out to the screen. And then we check, does the before value equal the reverse value? And if so, we say what you enter is an exact palindrome, and we show the user. And then what we do is we go back up again to the top, and we stay in the loop until the user presses the cancel button. So let's try this. We type in Bob, and see Bob, it reverses Bob, and I entered an exact palindrome. Say I leave it blank and I click OK. It stays right here. This code made me go back up until I do it. Trying to get to there. Okay, super. So I'm going to type in dot saw I was Todd. And then I do this. And again, I entered a little sentence at dot saw I was Todd as an exact palindrome. And I will enter my name. And you can see that it's Odignac Nyerb is my name backwards, and it is not an exact palindrome. So I'm going to hit cancel, which breaks me on the loop, and I'm done.